Hey, what's up, everybody? Thank you for checking me out. My name is Echo Simpson. I'm a Ghanaian, and I live in Ghana. Well, you are watching this channel because somebody introduced you to it. It was recommended or suggested to you on YouTube. Basically, my YouTube channel is to connect Africans in the motherland to Africans in the diaspora. So thank you for checking me out. If this is your first time of watching my videos, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Yes. Do you remember the year of return and the positive vibes that it brought, or it is even bringing, to Ghana and Africa in general? Talk of the Wakanda City of Return. Talk about the Obokasi University. I mean, talk about the exodus, you know, the diaspora moving to the motherland, Ghana to be specific. I mean, I know others are moving to Uganda, Gambia, Tanzania, and all that. That is so beautiful. All right. So when it comes to Ghana, there are a lot of things that is happening. I've made mention of few, and I also know of one project that is going on. We call it Pan-African World Heritage Museum. Yes, it's being built by Honorable Kojo Yanka. Yes, he's a very renowned personality here in Ghana. Now, come to think of Ghana. Now, do you know we have 16 regions in Ghana, and every region has its capital city? Yes, we have it. So when you go to Ashanti region, we have Kumasi. When you come to Central region, my city, my region where I live, is Cape Coast. All right, so Central region has its capital being Cape Coast. In Accra, we have the Greater Accra, we have the Accra. Now, I know you would like to fly to Ghana. There is only one place you can fly to, which is Greater Accra, because that is the only international airport we have in Ghana. Now, come to my region, which is Cape Coast, which we call the hub of tourism because we have the castles, we have the canopy walkway and other things. And aside tourism, Cape Coast is the citadel of education. When you talk of education, this is where education started, with Infanta Pem, with Wesley Girls, with Holy Child, Ghana National. I mean, you have the big schools, renowned schools here in my city, Cape Coast. Now, there's this beautiful message going out there that Cape Coast is going to look different within the next 5 to 10 years. Yes, so if you're watching this and you have a plan of moving to Africa or Ghana, think of Cape Coast. Now, Cape Coast used to be the capital city of Ghana. Yes, so here we call it the ancient capital. This is where we had a capital city. But now it's been moved to Accra, I mean, so many years ago, and Accra has seen a lot of development. People will say Accra is choked because every development basically goes or start from there. Now, Cape Coast is kind of developed a bit, but we are yet to see that development. Now, there's this beautiful news going on that is going to benefit, I mean, the people of Cape Coast. Cape Coast is going to see a massive development through a $10 billion smart city project. Yes. Now, let me tell you more about this project. The ancient city of Cape Coast is set to undergo a massive transformation under a $10 billion project to befit its status as the tourism heartbeat and the citadel of education in Ghana. Dubbed the Cape Coast Green City, the project birthed by MemDev Ghana Limited, a construction firm and a lead consultant and facilitator, is a partnership between several local and foreign partners and investors. The partners would use their capacities to ensure sustainable, diverse, and integrated and strong development for the region. The foreign partners include SteadyX and Hitachi Technologies, an information technology firm, with the support from the chiefs and people of Cape Coast and the government of Ghana as far as the diaspora. Yes, you watching this video right now. Okay, so the project, aside tourism, education, health sector would also benefit from this $10 billion project. So Cape Coast development, you know, is going to really go up. Now, this is the part that I really love, you know, when it comes to tourism. I know most of you have seen my videos when I travel around my country, you know, to show you exactly how we live, how we do things. So on tourism, the project will transform Cape Coast and Elmina. If you don't know Elmina, Elmina also is one of the towns that is housing
one of the dungeons, or we say the castles here in Ghana. So aside, you know, on the tourism side, the project will transform Cape Coast and Elmina into an international competitive tourism destination, using the vehicle of ecotourism to leverage the monumental, historical and cultural heritage of Cape Coast and central region at large. You know, so this whole project is going to highlight, you know, the city of Cape Coast. All right, it's going to look at advanced infrastructure, uninterrupted electricity, energy source. I'm even thinking, I think they should, you know, we should go into more of solar. Yeah, you know, we're going to have clean water, underground drainage. Yes, drainage is one of the problems that we're facing here in Ghana. I wouldn't say Cape Coast, in Ghana. Okay, so there's going to be solar farms. Like I said, there's going to be solar farms and smart city engineering. An airport, do you remember that, is it a year or two ago, myself, Candyman, and other youth who are in Cape Coast stood up and said, we need development. So we you know, we did a little demonstration. We went out to town, and then, you know, we were in red, you know, marching here and there with placards saying that we need airport. And last year, before the election, the winning party, you know, during its manifesto reading said, we have heard your cry, and then we will build you an airport. So airports will be built together with the construction of first-class roads, among many other modern facilities, to make Cape Coast the first administrative capital of the then Gold Coast, a model city. When it comes to tourism here, I mean, Cape Coast lacks a little bit, okay, apart from the castles and all that. We need, there is a lagoon that needs to be used. Yes, the lagoon is very close to the sea. You know, I think it gets its source from the sea or whatever, I don't know. But the lagoon is left unattended to. So this project is going to look at the Cape Coast Fossil Lagoon and then the Kakum National Park, which has been a source of worry to us. And, you know, I mean, the resident here, you know, so concerning the dredging. So they're going to take care of this lagoon and put it into a proper use. I know they're going to have amusement park, hotels, highway rest shops, recreational resorts, barbecue, botanical garden, and kayaking. You know, kayaking, all these things should be added to our attractions to retain our tourist areas here in Ghana. You know, we also have forts and castles. All of these are going to be renovated under this 10 billion smart city project. So hey, I'm glad that we're getting this thing going. You know, I mean, Cape Coast needs a lot of development. So if you're watching this video and then you want to look at investment, I think you should look a little bit to Cape Coast. So I made a video previously that Cape Coast is developing bit by bit. And so there are a lot of lands around Cape Coast. You wouldn't get it in the Cape Coast city itself. They are, you know, neighboring lands or communities that are, you know, ready to also get its fair share of development. So if you want to think of getting the land, I think you should look at, you know, neighboring rural or village communities that is a bit closer to Cape Coast. Get a land and start building your project. So hey, thank you very much for checking.